ago, prophets knew Christ would come, born a Jew, come to make all things new. Bear our burden, freely pardon. Ring, bells, ring, ring, ring. Sing, choir, sing, sing, sing. When he comes, when he comes, who will welcome? God in time, God in man, this is God's timeless plan. He will come as a man, born of woman, God and human. Ring, bells, ring, ring, ring. Sing, choir, sing. Mary hailed, though afraid, she believed, she obeyed. He will whom God is laid, still expected, nurtured, protected. Ring, bells, ring, ring, ring. Sing, choir, sing, sing, sing. When he comes, when he comes, who will welcome? Journey ends where a Bethlehem shines like a star. Stable door stands ajar. Son of Mary, Savior God tarry. Ring, bells, ring, ring, ring. Sing, choir, sing, sing, sing. When he comes, Jesus comes, we will welcome.
Welcome to you all, and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you. It's wonderful to gather together on this most wondrous night as we celebrate the God who loves us enough to come and live among us. And so we welcome you all to this service. We welcome especially visitors and those who may not have been with us for a while. It is good to all be here together. We hope that this service will enable us to enter into the joy and wonder of this night. So let us gather together in the peace of Christ. The peace of our Lord Jesus be with you all.
And also with you.
Share that. Thank you all for your hard work.
Oh, come.
please join me in the call to worship. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. The light of Christ is here. Comfort, comfort my people, says your God. The light of Christ is here. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it.
The light of Christ is here.
Hear the good news of great joy. Unto us is born a Savior who is Christ the Lord.
The light of Christ is here.
We continue with our children's choir.
Hear now these words of Scripture from the prophet Isaiah, the 9th chapter. We shall read the 2nd through the 7th verses. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The Lord sent a word against Jacob, and it fell on Israel, and all the people knew it. May God bless to our hearing this reading from God's holy word. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
At this time, we invite the children to come forward as we celebrate our Christmas story. I'm going to have you all help me in joining in the story and sharing the story. So if you all will come and be seated here, come on forward and take one star. Can you take one star? Because you're going to use the star to help me tell the story, okay? So make sure everybody gets one star. Okay. And then if you all can be seated and make sure you can see the manger scene, okay? Just have a seat. Thank you. Can you take a star, please? Okay. All right. And as we tell our story, there will be times where I'm going to have you hold your star to your heart, okay? And then there may be times where we hold it up, you'll follow my lead, or wave it around to help show the light of Jesus. But then we'll always bring it back to our heart until the end of the story, okay? Okay, so let's hold it to our hearts and gather around as we tell the story, because tonight is a night like no other night. We have been waiting for this night for weeks. Each week, we have gotten a little more light, the light of hope and peace and joy and love. And you all are holding a star, which is part of that light. And now, the waiting is almost over. So tonight is a night to sing and dream our way to Bethlehem, a little town in the hills south of Jerusalem. At the center of town is an inn, and on this night, the inn is crowded with people looking for a place to sleep and something to eat. But behind the inn is a stable, and in the stable, it is dark. There are only a couple of sheep, and they are almost asleep. All is quiet and still.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light.
the night gets darker, the last two travelers come down the road to Bethlehem. They are a young woman and a young man, and the woman is expecting a baby any day now. They are Mary and Joseph from Nazareth, and they have walked for 6 days to come to this town where King David was born so long ago. They have come because the Roman emperor wants each one to be counted so he can take their money as a tax. But it's late and the stars are rising in the sky. And Mary is so tired. Where will they sleep? There's no room in the inn, but they find a place to rest in the stable with the animals.
Once in royal David city stood a lowly cattle shed where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother.
Now it is getting really late. It is the middle of the night and the stars are high in the sky. But even though a great light is coming into the world does not notice it. The world does not notice this couple in the stable. And yet it is like the whole creation is holding its breath, waiting for something wonderful to happen. All of a sudden, from the stable comes the cry of a newborn baby. And that baby is who?
Jesus.
Jesus, the light of the world. Mary wraps the baby in a blanket and places him gently in the manger which Joseph has filled with straw. Imagine the God of the whole creation being welcomed into the world in such a lowly manger. Outside Bethlehem, there are shepherds watching their sheep. Then all of a sudden, the darkness of the night disappears, and there is a great light. And in the middle of that light is an even bigger light, the faces of angels. The shepherds hear a voice from the sky saying, "Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news of great joy, joy for all people. Today, in the city of David, a Savior is born, and he is Christ the Lord." Then more angels appear, a whole heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to all people." So the shepherds run across the fields to Bethlehem, to the stable behind the inn, and they find there the Holy Family. So they creep forward quietly, filled with mystery, and they find the baby who is the Son of God. The whole stable is full of love and mystery.
Oh.
Now, camels are coming up the road to Bethlehem. They carry great kings, the wise ones, the magi. They have come from far in the east, beyond the Arabian desert, maybe even as far as the Caspian Sea. And they are coming because they are following a star, a wild star. A wild star. They were following it wherever it goes to find the king it will show them.
We three kings of Orient are very gifts we traverse afar.
Kings have arrived, and their journey ends in a new kind of king. Their restlessness rests at last. They fall to their knees, and they give him gifts. Bright gold, sweet-smelling frankincense, and bitter myrrh brought so far with so much love. And now we, too, have come to this manger. We have come following the star to the place where Jesus lies. We come, like so many people have come through the ages, to bring our gifts to the Christ child. So as we sing our last song, you all can gently take turns. And as we sing our last song, I want you to bring your star and to place it gently in the manger or around the manger, remembering that we come and we bring our gifts to Jesus. You don't have to write your names. You'll just bring your star and place it in the manger and enter into this mystery of Christmas. And then when you finish, you can go back to sit with your families. Continue to bring our gifts to the Christ child as we share our offerings.
Tears are falling, hearts are breaking, how we need to hear from God. You've been promised, we've been waiting, welcome Holy Child, welcome Holy Child.
Hope that you don't mind our manger, how I wish we could have known the long awaited Holy Stranger, make yourself.
Around you, breathe our air and walk our sod. Rob our sins and make us holy, perfect Son of God, perfect Son of God. Welcome to our.
Let us pray. O God, on this wondrous night, we are so grateful for all your gifts, but most especially for your Son, Jesus Christ, who came to show your love among us, the light of the world. Receive these offerings as a token of our gratitude and use them to make light known in our world. Amen.
In story and in song, we have celebrated the news of the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And now we are prepared to gather at the table of his enduring presence with us. This is a table where we are nourished and sustained, where we are strengthened, where we are forgiven. All are invited to come to this table. Come not because you must, but because you may. Come not because you are strong, but because you are at times weak. Come not because you are perfect, but because in our imperfection we have need of the forgiving, sustaining love of God. I invite you to join with me in prayer, and then following that, I will ask the elders serving communion to come forward. We will invite the congregation to come forward by the center aisle to receive communion and to return to your pews. We'll ask the AV team to come down and to be served on the main floor, please. If you require gluten-free preparations, we have those. They will be available directly in front of the communion table. Let us join in prayer. Gracious God, as we gather at this table this night, we do so with hearts that are full of hope, hearts that need your healing touch. We ask that you would be with us and strengthen us as we gather this night. As we partake of this meal, we ask that you would nourish and strengthen us by it, that we may carry your light forth to a darkened world, and that we may share the hope of your presence with all we encounter. We make this prayer in the name of your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. I did neglect to mention that as we are serving communion, if you are unable or uncomfortable coming forward, simply remain in your pew, and we will bring the elements to you in your seat after the congregation has been served. On the night that our Lord Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it. And he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same manner, our Lord also took the cup after they had supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he returns."
Over the skies of Bethlehem appeared a star, while angels sang to lowly shepherds. Three wise men seeking truth traveled from afar, hoping to find the child from heaven. Jesus, may you receive the honor. Jesus, may you receive the honor that you're due. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. Oh Lord, I bring an offering to you. We bring an offering.
Join with pray. Gracious God, as we depart this table, we do so with thanksgiving for a joyous meal shared with brothers and sisters, both known to us and unknown to us. We ask that you would nourish and strengthen us by the gifts that we have sustained this night, that you would enable us to lay aside those things that we wish to lay aside and to take up afresh the faith, the hope, and the grace that you offer so freely to the world. We ask that you would go forth with us as we prepare to go forth this night, and hold us always in your enduring love. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
A reading from the Gospel of John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. As a representation of the light of Christ coming into the world, as we sing our last hymn, Silent Night, we will light candles, beginning from the Christ candle and the Advent wreath, which we will pass to the ushers, and they will then pass the light to you. Please be sure to tilt the candle that is unlit rather than the candle that is lit as we share this representation of the light of Christ.
Oh,
have seen Christ, the light of the world. So let us go now and share that light and wonder and joy in all the world. And as you go, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and abide with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.